Hello YouTubers, welcome to my NetSec YouTube channel. This is Johnny again. Today's video is going to present it how to upgrade CyberArk PAS solution from 10.1 to 11.5. I got a request from some audience telling me to show how to do CyberArk PAS upgrading. So I was planning this lab for quite a long time, last couple weeks. I already built the 10.1 lab in my environment. So I'm wondering if I can directly upgrade 10.1 to 11.5, or do I need to jump into some middle versions? Based on some documentation, especially for 10.5, it's saying if you are on 10.1, you have to go to 10.3 first for PVWA, and then you can upgrade 10.5. So I'm wondering, maybe I need to go through some middle versions, but I would like to give it a try to do the directly upgrade from 10.1 to 11.5. This is my lab topology. I have four core PAS components: Vault.41, PVWA.42, CPM.43, PSM.44, and using my AD.12, which is my same AD server as 11.4. Based on the upgrade guide, there's a couple of changes you need to make. One thing is regional and language options. During the upgrade, of course, it's best to have a backup before you do upgrading. Here is all upgrading process. Here is after upgrade, what you need to do. So basically, that's all steps shows in CyberArk documentation version 11.5. I already have Vault, PVWA, CPM, PSM, and my AD. Just for quickly presented the setup, I'm just gonna log in as one of my LDAP user, and I'm gonna do RDP to my remote server and also PSSH to my remote Linux server. That works well. This is for SSH session to one of the remote cloud server. First time connection. So it has been recorded. So both works well. So it proves my setup, at least CPM, PSM, PVWA, AD integration, and the Vault all works well. I already run a CPN to see the password has been changed. Now let's start it to work on our upgrade. I'm gonna start it from Vault. The installation files has been copied and extracted here, client server. Again, before you do upgrade, you need to have a good backup. It will be running all components on a virtual machine snapshotted. After you back it up, before you upgrade Vault, it's best to disable the CPM services. There's a no private ARC related service here. Go back to Vault. We're gonna stop all CyberArk services. if you already installed the DR server, so you may want to disable those DR services as well. Stop. Okay, and then private ARC services, database. There are 5 services you have to stop it. Make sure there's no any private ARC clients running. So this is my version 11.5 installation file folder. Find out the setup.exe file, run as administrator. Setup has detected an existing version of CyberArk Digital World on your computer. Would you like to upgrade to version 11.5.0? Yes. Data will be converted during the upgrade. If there's data in the world isn't English, your world is not configured correctly for a successful upgrade. Cancel the upgrade and use the documentation to configure your world. Then restart the upgrade. We are running on English. So would you like to install component distribution? No, we don't need that. It is upgrading world database. So finished. World server is back online now. Let's take a look at services. Event notification service is up. Launcher container is up. Private ARC. Database service is up. Remote control agent. I didn't install that. Private ARC server is up. We are good to go. Let's start the server. All looks normal as before. Eleven.5 is up. Firewall contains external rules. No, that's okay. Private ARC here. I didn't install the latest version of private ARC, but I'm assuming they're the same. Should be fine. CyberArk 1. Perfect tools. Yeah, it seems like all users are here. Cannot tell if anything wrong here. So now let's go back to our PVWA. Refresh this page. Our account should be timed out. Okay, web page is still valid. Let's log in as a local account, CyberArk local account first, administrator account, sign in. I cannot impersonate the account because I logged in the vault here. So let me log off. And still be able to log in. I don't see any issues here. Let's look at the health status. CPM is off, PSM is disconnected. CPM account. CPM services is disabled. Stopped, let's start them. Look at PSM service, here. I didn't touch that part. Supposed to be okay. The reason why we need to disable CPM account is it doesn't want to experiencing the password rotation issues here. But PSM services, we didn't touch that. Let's look at here. It's still running. Let's go back to PVWA, refresh the page for system health. Okay, all are working well. Let's give it testing. We're gonna do password change rotation. We're gonna do remote session and see if it still works. We can sign out. We're gonna using our AD account as we did last time. AD integration is still fine. We're gonna use in V10 admin 1, log into our AD server, which we did before. This is the same testing as we did last time. You have been recorded. I don't see any issue here. How about the SSH session? To a mine of my remote cloud server. Connect. You see, you have been recorded. Now I'm going to test in CPM. Gonna change the password, V10 admin 1, and Shuka and password. Now we'll confirm the CPM is still working. I don't have permission under this account to do that. Let's log out using administrator account to give it a try. Change the password immediately. Same thing on the SSH session. I want to change your password for NetSec. I want to change this account password as well. So I have this password here. Change. Okay. CPM change password. Let's see if it was successful or not. Looks like successful. Let's see password here. It's already been changed. We're gonna do connect again. perfectly. I don't see any issue here. System health still good. Last try is for NetSec account. Let's see the password. Not changed yet. Password change was failed. Operation system. So from what I see, the PVWA 10.1 is still able to work with Vault 11.5. CPM also can change the password. So I'm going to continue to do testing and upgrading and recording more videos regarding this update. Thank you for watching.